All right, Yeshua the Christ bless each and every one of you, and you are welcome, and I thank Yah for your lives. All right, so there are a number of topics that I hope to be able to touch on, but we'll see. Okay, we'll see how the Holy Spirit flows. I'm flowing with Him. All right, so I want to first welcome you guys, and I thank Yah for your lives. And I want to start by saying that if I could give this share a topic, I guess I would, of two topics, I'd probably name it Godlessness in the Time of Terror, or Terrorism. Godlessness in the Time of Terrorism. Or I would entitle it something like, And They Repented Not. Okay? Because those are the two points that I really want to focus on. Godlessness in these days of terror. There's still godlessness, and I'm going to show you examples of it. And I'm also going to show you what the scripture says concerning people's mind and heart towards repentance in the last days. And so when we look at the recent events that have occurred in France, all right, and that's happening throughout the earth, all right, it has been happening, okay? We see a lot on television concerning France, but terrorism didn't end with 9/11, and it or 9/11, and it didn't start with 9/11, all right? It's going on and has been going on and still going on throughout the earth in various places. If you go to my channel page, you'll see that I have several playlists that are there that show you testimonies of people who have been victims of terror in various places. In particular, Nigeria, you'll find quite a few testimonies there from both Christians and Muslims who have fallen prey to the terrors of Boko Haram and the like. You'll see a share there of the 200 and something schoolgirls that were abducted from their school, and coming up next month, it will be 2 years, 2 years. And where are they? Do people still think about them? I think about them, and I'm sure their parents think about them. I'm sure people in their nations think about them. I'm sure their friends that managed to escape think about them. But how many people who were standing up and holding signs saying, bring back our girls, are thinking about them today? Did they think they just disappeared into thin air? No, but we don't hear much about them. When we look at the things that happen in Paris, it's horrific. It's horrible. It's absolutely horrible. But these things will continue. And as I said, they have been going on. For the last 6 years in Nigeria alone, in 6 years, in the northern, mostly in the northern part of Nigeria, but we see that they are still shifting, all right? In the last 6 years, over 20,000 people have been killed in that country alone, known as the Giant of Africa, because there are millions of people there, and because of their economic power and stability as a nation, all right? And being rich in minerals and oil and all of these things. But we don't hear about it. But God sees and He knows. And in the midst of that, you still have a godly people. You still have people who are not afraid to go to church. Even though I have images on my page where people are blowing up their churches, they still get up and go. But when you compare that, all right, and not to say that everyone in Nigeria is godly, but when you compare that to what I'm going to show you here that occurred a couple of days ago in France, you're going to see a difference. A couple of days ago, during their time of mourning after these attacks, the deputy mayor was interviewed, and she was asked some questions about, you know, how, I'm just paraphrasing, but how's the nation going to go forward now that you have curfews, now that they're, you know, still doing raids, now that there have been terror attacks, now that these people have been killed, and their chances are that there will be additional attacks. You know, how are you going to cope? What are you doing? What is life like? Her response caused me to think of a particular verse in the book of Revelation. And her response to his questions that I just paraphrased, and I'll include the link to that video, but her response was, we're not afraid. We're outside. We're having drinks on the terrace. Did you hear that? She said, we're not afraid. We're outside. We're having drinks on the terrace. And you know, that caught my attention because this was supposed to be a time of mourning. This was during the time of mourning that she said this. She said, we're outside. I'm not afraid. We're not afraid. We're outside. We're having drinks on terrace. And it brought my mind to the scripture in Revelation. All right, Revelation 9. I didn't know it was chapter 9. All right, I remember verses, but the numbers that go with them, that's a challenge for me. All right, but I'm going to start with Revelation chapter 9, verse 13. All right, and during this time, it's speaking about the sixth trumpet. All right, and the sounding of the sixth trumpet. All right, and it says, and the sixth angel sounded, and I heard a voice from the four horns of the golden altar which is before God, saying to the sixth angel which had the trumpet, loose the four angels which are bound in the great river Euphrates. And the four angels were loosed, which were prepared for an hour and a day and a month and a year, for to slay the third part of men. And the number of the army of the horsemen were 200,000,000. And I heard the number of them. And thus I saw the horses in the vision, and them that sat on them, having breastplates of fire, and of jacinth, and of brimstone. And the heads of the horses were the heads of lions, and out of their mouths issued fire, smoke, and brimstone. By these three was the third part of men killed, by fire, and by the smoke, and by the brimstone, which issued out of their mouths. For their power is in their mouth and in their tails, for their tails were like unto serpents and had heads, and with them they do hurt. But this is the verse that I'm going to read now that she reminded me of. Verse 20, it says, and the rest of the men which were not killed by these plagues, yet repented not of the works of their hands, that they should not worship devils and idols of gold and silver and brass and stone and of wood, which neither can see, nor hear, nor walk, neither repented they of their murders, nor their sorceries, nor their fornication, nor their thefts. Did you see that? Did you hear that? With all of this that's going on, one third of mankind will be killed. This sounds like a great army, okay? Even greater than what we're seeing right now with this ISIS, all right? I mean, we see all the armies of the earth that are gathering together, all right, to that central location. They'll all be gathering. They're making their way over. Look at a map. See where Paris is. See where Italy is. See where Russia is. See where Turkey is, all right? That's the seat of Satan. The word has not lied. It is the seat of Satan. We see that they just had the G20 conference there. Mm-hmm. And President Obama was there. All right. And so they have the G20 conference. And I'm not saying that President Obama is the beast. Time will tell. But I know one thing. That seat is in Turkey. So keep your eye on Turkey. In fact, in recent days, and I just want to touch on this briefly. In recent days, several of you, followers of Christ, so if I responded to some of you, listen, several of you have commented, and I haven't responded yet, okay? Sometimes, even if I respond, I may hide your comment again because I don't want people to attack you. But several of you have come to that. The Lord, the Holy Spirit has led you to that share that I did on Turkey, right? The one that I said that every day I get cussed out on that share at least 3 or 4 times, okay? Or insulted in various languages, okay? All right, mainly the Turkish language, because they couldn't see it. But since this attack on Paris and since the G20 conference, they have been completely silent, because I believe by the Spirit of God, God is opening their eyes and they're beginning to see. All right. And they are seeing that what has been stated on that share and on even a more detailed teaching that I have uploaded to the channel, they're seeing that these things are coming to pass as the scripture says. But what's more amazing is some of you who are seeing the same things, even though you may have believed something else, even though your doctrine may have been taught in a different way, or maybe you didn't even have an understanding on it at all. The Holy Spirit is opening the eyes and the hearts and the ears of those who really and truly want to know the truth. And I, for that, say praises, all praises be to the Most High, Yah. But back to this subject here about not repenting, all right? You see that no matter how bad things were, And it's going to be worse than what's going on now. It's going to be worse when that sixth angel sounds that trumpet. One third of mankind is dead. And the scripture tells us that the men that did not die, meaning mankind that did not die, it says, yet repented not of their works, of their hands. And it goes on to say, in the worship of their idolatry of gold and silver and brass, neither of their murders nor of their sorcery. And listen, if the Lord wills, I've been meaning to do this for some time, okay? I'm wanting to do it for some time, but all in Yah's will. If you truly understood that word sorcery, you'd know that it is not speaking about some medicine in your cabinet. Although it's the word pharmacia, you have to know the spiritual meaning of what's being said here, okay? The spiritual meaning of what's being said. They didn't have pharmacies back then, okay? Even though prophecy can foretell things. What was spoken of is the sorcery, the medicine, the potions, the concoctions that are used in witchcraft. If you understood how witchcraft worked and the spirituality part of witchcraft, it's not just words, speaking words, all right? There are concoctions. Why do you think they call them witch doctors, okay? Witch doctors, because they would come up with medicine or bewitching potions that could be used to bewitch people. They could pour out libation, come up with concoctions to pour out libations. They use things to charm people and to beguile people and to bewitch them. So you have to be spiritually minded and understand how the spiritual world works, not only for good, but you have to know your enemy and know the things that the enemy uses, all right? In his world. So if the Lord wills, I will share that at some other time. And basically, I've just shared it right there. All right? But don't take my word for it. Look into it and study it and see. All right? It is not limited to what's in your medicine cabinet, okay, and what modern medicine is dishing out. In fact, I would say it's not even speaking about that. It's speaking about the sorcery. When you look at what's going on now, a lot of people are going into sorcery, and that will increase. That's why the scripture says they will not repent of it. Why? Because people will turn to sorcery to gain power. Listen, principalities are shifting, okay? So the reason why the West is seeing a lot of terrorism is because the principalities have shifted. Things that were in times past in Iraq or Iran or northern Nigeria and all these places, those things that used to occur, they have been killing people for the longest. In the last six years in Nigeria, northern Nigeria mainly, but they are making their way down to the south as well. But in northern Nigeria, they have killed over 20,000 people. Do you know how many people that is? That's more than one 9/11 attack per year. Think of everyone that was killed during 9/11 in all locations. That's more than one a year when you think about 20,000 people. So listen, just because you're just hearing about it doesn't mean it hasn't existed. What you're seeing now is a shifting of principalities. And so you export your abortion, you export all of your godlessness, you export your homosexuality, you export all of these wicked principalities to other nations. Do you not think they're going to just, do you think they're just going to sit there and not export some to you? No, it's an exchange. And what we're seeing is a shifting of principalities. So the terror that has been happening in other nations have now come to the West. Yet, they are repenting not. Even during their so-called time of mourning, they're out celebrating and drinking and sitting on their terrace. No one's crying in the street for the souls and the lives that are being killed in the street. And we can say that about here in America, the men and women who are being murdered in our streets. Who's crying for them? Not marching, but I mean mourning for them and crying out to God and saying, Lord, how have we opened the door to this Trojan horse? How have we opened the door to allow this to come in? And that's another subject when you think about the Syrian refugees. There's a lot of talk now. I believe President Obama says that, you know, Republicans are fighting against widows and orphans. Nobody's fighting against widows and orphans. The scripture says that true religion and undefiled before the Most High Yah is to care for widows and orphans in their time of need. And believe me, I know that one, okay? And I strongly believe in it. I strongly believe in it and have a life testimony to match my belief, okay? But listen, that doesn't mean we close our eyes and throw away wisdom. mixed in among those widows and orphans are some dangerous, dangerous soldiers of Satan, who arm themselves with what they call the vest of the mother of Satan, the mother of Satan vest, who come in with an agenda to steal, kill, and destroy. We have to be wise, but more than that, we have to repent individually, as a family, as a people of the Most High Yah, and as a nation. Everybody has to call on their own God. Everybody, as in the day of Jonah, when they were going to throw him off of that ship. Before then, they said, every man cry out unto his God. It's getting personal now. It's not about your church. It's not about your denomination. It's not about what they're teaching in your group, in your sect, in your camp, whoever. It's about a one-on-one with the Most High Yah. And we have to be ready no matter where we are in the earth. I've been speaking to those and encouraging those who are considering moving abroad. You, be not afraid. If this unbeliever who boasts in secular and being a part of a secular nation can live without fear, then you can live without fear. Just allow the Holy Spirit to lead you. There's no place on the earth that the beast system will not reach, but we are in the world, but not of it. Amen. And God will care for his people. Just allow him to take you and lead you where he would have you to be. We see on the news that they're coming in from Honduras. They're coming in from Turkey. They're coming in everywhere. These are those locusts and those armies that are coming in. All right. The locusts of Satan. All right. There's a difference. And those of you who study scriptures, you know what I'm speaking of. I'm not speaking about the armies of God. But you have to be prepared in your spirit and in your mind. And you have to be a person of repentance. Because we see from the scripture that no matter how bad things get, there will still be people, despite one third of the earth being killed, they still will not repent. They still will not repent. So I'm asking you today to not be as the heathen, not to be as these godless people who refuse to repent despite the plagues, despite the calamity, despite the terror. They refuse to repent and rather boast in their godlessness. But you trust in God. Give your life to him. Cry out to him. Call upon him now while he will answer, while he will hear you and answer you. Today is the day of salvation. And I say this to those who are called and those who are chosen. Even among the chosen, you have a choice to refuse the call. He gives us free will. But I pray that the day that you hear his voice, you will not harden your heart. Y'all bless you and follow after Christ.